This video contains scary content and disturbing visuals, not suitable for younger audiences. Viewer discretion advised.
There are a number of enemies in each gate, which are usually made to scare the crap out of us, and these are the ones which do it the best.
Scary enemies have been around since the old coin-op arcade, even through today's survival horror experiences.
For all viewers who suggest the originals of Pyramid Head, Andross, Shodan, Alma, or Nemesis, well, they're not present in this list, as they are not classified as standard enemies, more of iconic characters or video game bosses.
These enemies have always had a spot as some of the most downright creepiest and scariest parts to a game. Whether it's down to the visual or aesthetic look, its fast speed, or invulnerability to the player's attacks, it's time for the Top 80 Scariest Game Enemies.
This is the Top 80 Scary Game Enemies. Number 80. Time Lord. New Zealand Story.
For such a pleasant and dreamy game, the most shocking part for any player was seeing this horrifying enemy appearing out of nowhere. The enemy appears when the player takes too long to complete a certain stage. Rather like the timer in Super Mario Bros., instead of a fast-paced music track, the game just throws this winged demon on the player.
Number 79. Angry Sun. Super Mario Bros. 3.
An enemy that still haunts many gamers to this day. It's first encountered on Desert Land, and is at first a random sprite or part of the background. Further on in the level, the sun will appear to freak out and attempt to fall down and attack the player, before flying up to the sky. While there are no decent means to destroy this enemy other than with a Koopa shell, it can be deemed a nuisance and a terrifying enemy on the first encounter especially. Angry Sun also appeared in Mario Kart Wii.
Number 78. Nemo. Donkey Kong Land.
Nemos are a large-shelled creature encountered in the Game Boy game Donkey Kong Land. They only appear in the level Nautilus Chase. Nemos actually chase Donkey Kong and Diddy Kong throughout the level. When they are first encountered, they appear to be sleeping, but will soon emerge from their shells as the monkeys pass by. The Nemo will then follow behind them at a fast pace through the coral-filled level. If they are not fast enough, the enemy will attack the Kongs. These foes can be hard to avoid, as they cannot be defeated. At some point, however, the Nemos will stop running after the heroes and huddle back up in a corner somewhere around the coral.
Number 77. Phanto. Super Mario Bros. 2.
Phantos appeared as semi-common enemies in Super Mario Bros. 2, often in caves or vases. Phantos simply remain immobile unless the key they are guarding moves. Once this happens, a Phanto will ceaselessly chase whoever stole the key. Phantos cannot be avoided, and can only be escaped by using the key it was guarding to unlock a door. If players simply drop the key while Phanto is chasing them, the creature will fly away and leave them alone, at least until the key is picked up again.
Number 76. Evil Otto. Berserk.
Though he might not look like much now, this little pixelated smiley face was enough to kill two team players with heart attacks shortly after posting high scores. His purpose is to quicken the game, and if the player is touched by him, they were killed instantly. What makes this enemy so frightening is that he's immortal and can go through walls and he's always coming after the player.
Number 75. Bulldozer. Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles.
These large enemies are found on the first level of the game. They are considered more of a hazard than an enemy, and will be an instant kill to the player should they cross paths. Bulldozers are positioned in the levels to avoid players attempting to jump down certain manhole covers on foot. While bulldozers appear on later levels, they are less scary.
Number 74. Death. Gauntlet 2.
An enemy who cannot be defeated by any physical attacks. Devs will attempt to chase after the player and drain player's life by 200, and then destroy themselves at the same process. Devs can be defeated by magic potions, but these items are rare. More than once, players are bound to find more than one death in the same room.
Number 73. Ultimate Chimera. Mother 3.
The Ultimate Chimera is a creature created in the Chimera Laboratory during Chapter 7 of Mother 3. Like its name implies, it is indestructible and can defeat the player instantly by merely being touched. Instead, it needs to be avoided and ran from. The Ultimate Chimera also appears in the New York City stage in Super Smash Bros. Brawl, and is true to the series.
Number 72. D.E. Banjo-Kazooie.
Teehees are ghastly green ghosts, with facial features resembling those of standard gremlins. These enemies are found in just about all areas of Mad Monster Mansion, hovering around and chasing after the player, while snickering all the way. Physical attacks and eggs do not harm this enemy. The Wonder Wing move is the only thing that can defeat them. Teehees are also encountered in the garden maze outside the mansion, as well as larger versions found in the church. Teehees also bear a remarkable resemblance to the Twinkly Munchers from Freezeezy Peak.
Number 71. Big Blurb. Yasha's Story.
Big Blurbs are giant versions of Blurbs, native to the jungle river of Yoshi's Island. Big Blurbs will eat anything near the river, so Yoshi must be careful when in their vicinity. Big Blurbs act a lot like Bubba and Boss Bass, but are larger and more aggressive. Big Blurbs appear only in Stage 4-2, Jungle Puddle. They can jump very high out of the water and have excellent aim. If a Yoshi falls into the water, there's almost no chance of getting out in one piece.
Number 70. Smoky Prog. Pikmin.
The Prog itself is a dark green and black creature with glowing white eyes, and constantly emits a cloud of gas that is poisonous to both the Pikmin and Alima, which is usually behind the Prog. The Smoky Prog will make its way towards the landing site upon emerging, and so it's necessary to kill it to avoid interference with the day's plans. It has an incredibly high defense, so it takes a while to kill. When killed, however, it drops a golden pearl, which, if carried to an onion, will produce 100 Pikmin seeds.
Number 69. Chomps and Chomp Sharks. Yoshi's Island.
Chomps jump from the background hills and destroy everything that is below them. Chomps are first encountered a few levels into the game. There will come a point later into Yoshi's Island when a chomp shark will rush from behind and attempt to chomp on Yoshi. Chomp sharks usually appear over a wide pit and chomp through breakable platforms until they reach a solid platform.
Number 68. Metroids. Metroid.
Fortunately for the player, Metroids are fast and unpredictable. They eagerly cling to the player, draining their life until the player can shake them off. They can't be destroyed directly with the normal beam. The only way is to blast them with the ice beam and firing 5 missiles to destroy it. Defeated Metroids leave behind super energy and missile refills that quickly replenish stock.
Number 67. Sinistar. Sinistar.
Sinistar is a skeletal looking enemy who is a tough opponent to beat, whose mission is to try to destroy the player. Sinistars are created by minor enemy ships who salvage crystals from destroyed planetoids. The player must also collect these crystals in order to defeat Sinistar. The enemy worker ships must harvest 20 crystals before the Sinistar is completely formed. Once it is completely formed, digitized voice clips are heard while the Sinistar flies around, trying to collide with the player's ship in order to eat it.
Number 66. Zombies. Alone in the Dark.
The zombies in this game would randomly spawn off screen and then suddenly yet slowly walk into the room. What made this terrifying is that there was no music in most of the game until players got attacked, then the blaring battle music would suddenly start playing. You could literally go an hour exploring the house without an attack by a zombie, so when it came, it was sudden. Zombies generally attack the player in small, cramped, confined places, so attacking these enemies is scary and difficult.
Number 65. Ninja. Banjo-Tooie.
Minjos are the arch-enemies of the Jinjos and look exactly like them. First appearing in Witchy World, Minjos will initiate Jinjos from a distance, waving their arms and calling for help, but will spring into action when the player approaches, growling and chasing after them, giving off yellow sparks.
Number 64. Zombies. Conker's Bad Fur Day.
Zombies are undead squirrels which appear in the spooky chapter of Conker's Bad Fur Day and Conker Live Reloaded. All of the zombies are gray squirrels and come in both male and female genders. The only way they can be defeated is to be shot in the head with the use of the shotgun, which Conker receives from Greg. Zombies can be pretty scary due to their sudden rush attack when near to the player, and the player must shake free once they are grabbed.
Number 63. Piano and Mother Fish. Super Mario 64.
In the Big Boo's Haunt level of Super Mario 64, this seemingly harmless piano sits in the corner of a dark room. However, approaching it causes it to reveal its true nature, a man-eating piano which violently chomps and hops around the room in pursuit of Mario. Whether you're a kid or an adult, seeing that for the first time probably made you jump. The enemy can't be killed, and to make matters worse, one of the 8 red coins from the level is hidden underneath it. So in order to get to that star, it's necessary to disturb this phantom piano and risk musical death. Bubba Fish is found in the water of Tiny Huge Island, only as Tiny Mario. What's frightening is its instant kill to the player, if within range. The big fish will suddenly attack, and players lose a life if they're eaten.
Number 62. Snacker. Banjo-Kazooie.
Snacker is the shark that guards the waters of level 2 Treasure Trove Cove. Whenever you swim too far out into the crystal blue waters, he shows up to give you a reason to get back on land.
Number 61. Archvile. Dildo.
Archviles are emaciated-looking, yellowish-skinned humanoid figures with a grotesque appearance. These monsters can take a considerably high amount of damage, and their attack consists of a unique ability to engulf their enemies in flames by raising their arms up and summoning fire upon the targeted foe. The Archvile also has the power to resurrect other low-level monsters that they come across.
Number 60. Phantasms. Blood.
These restless phantoms harvest the souls of their victims with vicious scythes. Because they exist more in the land of the dead than the world of the living, they are only vulnerable when attacking. Phantasms screech when they are near a player, and suddenly fly face first into them. These enemies are more like jump scares. Most other weapons are next to useless against it, although a Tommy gun and shotgun will work best.
Number 59. Octobrain. Duke Nukem.
The Octobrain is a large, floating brain with tentacles, mean eyes, and huge teeth. It can expertly use incredible psychic powers, both as a means of movement and as a weapon. It also seems to be the most intelligent enemy in the game. It is at home both underwater and on land, and is the most notable underwater-based enemy.
Number 58. Cyber Demon. Doom.
The Cyber Demon is perhaps the most formidable enemy in the Doom series. The Cyber Demon will let out a loud animalistic roar when it spots the player, loud enough to be heard no matter how far away it is from the player. It attacks by firing barrages of 3 rockets. It is also the fastest moving monster in Doom, and its second fastest in Doom 2. The constant walk noises will in turn frighten the player even more.
Number 57. Skinhound. The Shivering Isles.
Skintowns are yet another bizarre species inhabiting the Shivering Isles. They are often found in and around ruins, accompanying other undead creatures. Other than their appearance, the only known ability is to run at high speeds from dark places. Bigger versions are also located near ruins, but have higher health statistics.
Number 56. Mantis and Hector MK2. Earth Defense Force Insect Armageddon.
The mantis has been observed jumping great distances. It uses its front legs for close-range weapons, sweeping and stabbing its enemies. The mantis also seems able to produce some sort of sonic blast wave. Its death animation also produces a large blast radius damaging anything nearby. A larger and much deadlier form of a Hector, being twice as tall as a standard Hector, it's only vulnerable in the large sphere on its chest. It has 5 different attacks. Its right arm fires huge globes of plasma energy and a cutting laser. Its left arm launches a multiple missiles or employs a barrage of plasma balls. Hector Mark IIs are also capable of performing a shockwave attack with its arms if certain EDF units get too close. Once defeated, Hector Mark IIs explode with such force that the damage radius is large enough to affect the environment and the players too.
Number 55. Hellhound. Call of Duty Black Ops.
They're essentially zombie dogs that are believed to be the mutated versions of Samantha's pet, Fluffy. They randomly spawn throughout the map every 4 to 7 rounds, and their sole objective is to kill the player by streaking towards them, either attacking with tooth and claw, or by exploding. The ground shakes whenever they spawn. There are two variants of the Hellhound, a standard Hellhound and a flaming one. While the actual enemy itself is scary, the model has presented numerous bugs and glitches of the online component of the game, such as freezing or related errors.
Number 54. Beheaded Kamikaze. Serious Sin.
Kamikazes are equipped with a recorder that emanates a very loud scream when the kamikaze is charging towards its victim. In general, kamikazes are one of the most dangerous enemies in the game. They're very fast and can sneak up on the player and inflict a large amount of damage, especially in harder difficulties. Kamikazes are scary enemies due to their screaming. Oh yeah, and they have no heads.
Number 53. Convicts. Dead Rising.
The convicts are psychopaths appearing in Dead Rising and Dead Rising Chop Till You Drop. There are three escaped inmates that ride around in a stolen military Humvee with a mounted 50 caliber machine gun. The convicts will roam Leisure Park at their free will, running and gunning down everything in sight, zombies and humans alike. Convicts are easily most of the troublesome and unpredictable of the foes in the game, due to their fast speed, high damage, and other such things. In fact, just hearing their theme music or vehicle lights in the distance is enough for certain players to avoid the park entirely. It's unclear exactly if the three are in fact bosses or just enemies, due to them not having any description in the player's journal, nor count toward the self-defense achievement and no health bar or death cutscenes. Unlike the rest of the psychopaths, the convicts respawn each night at midnight. However, they will disappear for good at the start of Case 8-1.
Number 52. Loot Midgets. Borderlands. Secret Armory of General Knox.
Loot Midgets are a type of midget appearing in the DLC, the Secret Armory of General Knox. Each of them hides in a different type of lootable object. Examples are Crimson Shorty, Dumpster Diver, Meat Popsicle, Mini Steve, and the Truxian Wrestler. Many players would have freaked out over the scream that they make once a loot midget jumped out at them from a normal lootable object.
Number 51. Slayer. The Suffering.
The Slayer is the embodiment of death by decapitation. It has long blades for arms and legs, and its head is held aloft by some sort of apparatus. Slayers can run along walls and ceilings, and paired with their considerable speed, can become difficult enemies. Slayers can be easily checked by the unusual clanking noise they make while moving. They rarely pose a threat until later on in the game, when they gain the ability to revive themselves from the dead.
Number 50. Flying Crownheads. Dementium, the Ward.
These enemies have it all. They're screamers, they look scary, and all they do is continuously fly at the player, coming from the Blanket of Darkness. They're super fast and can chase players down in an instant. Their agility and strength will make these monstrosities a challenge to kill, even with a firearm.
Number 49. Centaur. Fallout 3.
The Centaur is a scary looking beast with features of many different animals. It has some type of virus known as the Forced Evolutionary Virus, created by mixing animals into a vat for an experiment. Centaurs can pose, at best, a moderate threat level to players, but they are generally a weak enemy. Centaurs are known to sneak up on players unexpectedly, which can often result in panic moments. They spit slow-moving radioactive projectiles at a ranged attack. Centaurs are rarely found wandering alone, and so may indicate that super mutants are nearby.
Number 48. Big Daddy. BioShock.
Big Daddies communicate by haunting sounds similar to that of a whale call. If a Big Daddy not escorting a little sister comes across the player character, he will not attack unprovoked. However, if either the player or explosive gets too close to a little sister, the Big Daddy will get aggressive. There are two versions of the Big Daddy, Bouncers and Rosies. Bouncers, shown here, are short-range fighters which attack with their drill and are known to both charge at the player at incredible speeds and stamp the ground with their massive feet, stunning a player and making it difficult to move or escape. Rosies are long-range fighters equipped with a rivet gun and proximity mines.
Number 47. Husks and Abominations. Mass Effect 2.
Husks are synthetic zombies created by the Geth and charge at their enemies with freakish groans. Once close enough, they give off a powerful electric blast, which disables shields and causes massive damage. Abominations are a variant of the standard husk, and glow red rather than blue, and act as suicide troops. Abominations will start to glow as it charges towards its target, and will explode once they get close.
Number 46. Cyclops. Gears of War 2.
The Cyclops is an advanced drone seen in Gears of War 2. What makes him a formidable and terrifying enemy is his Lancer firearm, which is the default weapon for any standard gear. Cyclops are known to viciously attack the player from long distances with a hail of bullets, and then charge the player with the chainsaw up close. Cyclops themselves are instantly one of the most unpredictable enemies in the game.
Number 45. Wraiths. Prey.
Whenever video game or movie directors use children to portray something creepy, it usually works. Wraiths are first seen on some later levels, with glowing eyes, warped twisted voices, and run after the player. However, these spirits only appear relatively early in the game, and are conspicuously absent from the remainder. The human possession aspect is neither further explored or resolved, leaving something of a loose end to the plot.
Number 44. Shambler. Quake.
Shamblers are yeti-like, large beasts with blood-stained white furs, very large mouth displaying enormous fangs, no visible eyes, and razor-sharp claws. Their furious melee claws do enormous damage, and at distances can attack by projecting a bolt of electricity towards the player. Shamblers are usually only found in castle levels, but have occasionally appeared in a few military levels as well.
Number 43. Spider Splicers. BioShock 2.
Spider Splicers are spiders that have gone to an extreme. Able to stick onto the ceiling, perform acrobatic feats impossible to a pure human, and twirl red-hot hooks from afar at their foes, Spider Splicers are known for being the most insane splicers in terms of their voice quotes. Their screams and death wails provoke a very scary enemy who are both formidable and grotesque in appearance.
Number 42. Bagged Kids. Painkiller.
Small children with bags over their head, found in the orphanage level of Painkiller. These enemies will run blindly around and will detonate within reach of the player. The enemies have a disturbing and strange voice when spotted, and the actual identity of the child inside remains a mystery, and this in itself creates its scary, foreboding appearance.
Number 41. Flood. Halo series.
Based on the behavior of viruses and certain bacteria, the Flood were intended to be disgusting and nasty. The creatures were constructed from the corpses of bodies of former combatants. The Flood are driven by a desire to infect any sentient life they encounter, and are depicted as a big threat. The player's discovery of the Flood in Halo Combat Evolved is a major plot twist, and was one of the surprises that viewers noted positively upon its release. The Flood's return in Halo 2 and 3 was less enthusiastically praised. Reaction to the Flood has varied over the years, but they are still classed as a scary and unpredictable enemy in the Halo universe.
Number 40. Cultists. Fear 3.
Cultists are enemies in Fear 3 that were once Fairport civilians, but now have gone insane thanks to Alma's psychic influence. They're usually equipped with pipes and similar such items, but the more dangerous ones are armed with timed explosives or throwing knives. They dress in different clothes, but all of them have some kind of sign on their bodies, either a vortex on their face, or an A on their forehead or chest. They are encountered on interval 3 and 4, and are shown to worship Alma, where they seem to write everything in blood, usually to point that the most of their shrines were completely covered in it.
Number 39. Demonic Puppets. Dream Killer.
Demonic puppets are enemies encountered much later into the game, where Alice enters a patient's dream of Richard Little, who suffers from children, people, and little spaces. The level is full of strange children's toys, which are wired with explosives, but none of them are as scary as the demonic puppets, who stalk the player with knives and axes. These enemies are roughly twice the size of the player, and all of them have an evil grin.
Number 38. Berserker. Gears of War.
The Berserkers of Gears of War are huge, destructive, and nothing short of horrific. They're also blind and have a disturbing habit of standing around sniffing the air when they don't know where you are. Once they figure out where you are, they roar towards you like a freight train, smashing through stone obstacles in an attempt to reduce you to tiny bits. They're at the absolute scariest when you're running away from them and all you can hear is the engine-like noise of their running drawing rapidly closer.
Number 37. Rex, 3D Monster Maze.
This game deserves some serious credit. It was the first 3D game ever on a home computer. However, when you turned the corner and saw Rex coming, it was a seriously big scare, even in black and white, without sound and pixelated graphics. So scary, in fact, it was enough to make you hammer the keyboard. Rex is an instant kill if you manage to catch a player, and seeing the sheer size and freakish grin is enough to panic a gamer to this day.
Number 36. Meth Addict, Condemned 2.
Meth addicts are seen in the second level of Condemned 2, located inside Preston Hotel. They are occasionally seen running across rooms around meth labs and attacking the player. They suffer from extreme malnutrition and other health problems. Meth addicts will occasionally jump at the player, and this entices a quick time event, where the player must mash buttons to stop the enemy from being injected with the drug. This is also an easy way to eliminate meth addicts. At one point, a meth addict attacks a player from behind when the player opens a medicine cabinet in a bathroom.
Number 35. The Pack, Dead Space 2.
The Pack refers to a group of necromorphs that attacks its prey with overwhelming numbers. They move fast and constantly shriek. They are one of the few necromorphs created from the bodies of children. The Pack like to attack from behind and from all sides, disrupting players' movements. Due to their small size and fast movements, they can be difficult to hit.
Number 34. Skarik, Killing Floor.
The Skarik is a large specimen equipped with a chainsaw. It lumbers along unsteadily towards its target and tends to charge after taking sufficient damage. In combat, the Skarik is capable of delivering a series of extremely deadly blows from its chainsaw arm, which tends to catch the victim's body and pull him in closer. Its skin is like a thick leathery hide, and as a result, it's highly resistant to small arms fire.
Number 33. Puppets, Thief.
Puppets function much like faster, more terrifying zombies. They cannot be killed directly by means other than holy water, explosives, or flash bombs, though a backstab can disable one until Garrett draws too close to it. Clad in white straitjackets with wire cages covering their heads and hands, they are normally near silent, their presence primarily revealed only by the flickering of nearby electric lights as they approach. Should they detect prey, they quickly scream and rush to attack, flailing with their caged hands. It also bears mention that they can lie dormant, like the common zombie, appearing to be dead only to rise up and attack should an opponent come within a few feet.
Number 32. Dwellers, Chronicles of Riddick, Escape from Butcher Bay.
Dwellers are fast humanoid creatures that are found through the pit and dark tunnels. Many of them are found in dark, damp places, and as their name suggests, they appear unexpectedly from the shadows and attack up front. Dwellers also like to attack from behind, and it's best not to spend too long attacking them, as more of them will spawn.
Number 31. Nurses, Silent Hill series.
The Nurses are a recurring type of monster and a staple of Silent Hill series, making appearances of one or sort of another in all of the titles. The Nurses share many common traits across the entire series. Generally, these monsters wear uniforms that reflect those of the contemporary Nurses, though in the first Silent Hill games, the Nurses wear a much older form of attire, including cardigans rather than modern-day nurse uniforms. These monsters carry their own melee weapons, usually pipes, knives, and sometimes firearms. They are fairly aggressive and will surround the player, too. Nurses are also widely known due to their distinct noises and erratic movement patterns.
Number 30. Reapers and Crocodiles, Resident Evil 5.
The Reaper attacks primarily by using its upper claws to grab a target and using its middle siphoning talons to repeatedly puncture and shred the victim's abdomen, killing them instantly. The only two ways to kill a Reaper are to shoot the glowing abdominal sac when the armor plating shifts off to vent gas, or by hitting the Reaper with explosives powerful enough to obliterate its body completely. Crocodiles are encountered in the marshlands, when players enter waist-deep watered areas. The crocodile is a formidable and scary enemy, due to them killing with a single bite. Thankfully, crocodiles can be killed, although they only surface when prey is nearby. They are large, roughly 15 to 20 feet long, and appear to be albinos. The music and quiet tension of an enemy out there, stalking the player, drove the player's paranoia to new heights. It's interesting to note that if the player is with an AI partner, the crocodiles and the AI will mutually ignore each other.
Number 29. Heaven Smiles. Pillar 7.
Semi-invisible, cackling, humanish demon creatures called Heaven Smiles are the main enemies of this game here. You can't see them at first, but they announce their presence with a laugh, which you'll then know to switch to first-person mode to blow them away, either by hitting them a few times with your weapon or aiming for their instant kill weak spot. What's more is the demonic and insane clown laughter that comes from vanquishing them.
Number 28. Cougar. Red Dead Redemption.
Also known as the Mountain Lion, Puma, or Mountain Screamer, it's a very vicious and bloodthirsty predator that extreme caution must be taken in the event of an encounter. Cougars strike fear into the hearts of many players with their cry. They are one of the most vicious predators in the game, killing swiftly without remorse. One strike is enough to kill a horse, and two strikes can kill the player. Cougars are scarce animals, and the phrase,
"You don't find cougars, they find you,"
has arisen because of this.
Number 27. Ichthyosaur. Half-Life.
Ichthyosaurs are encountered in several water bodies of the original Half-Life, including a flooded laboratory and a reservoir behind a hydroelectric dam, sewage areas, and in Nimalith's chambers. They are often placid at first, but quickly become hostile. The speed and viciousness of the Ichthyosaur, combined with the poor underwater visibility, make the underwater areas of Half-Life some of the most frightening in the game. The Ichthyosaur was also seen in Half-Life 2, but only for a few seconds. It is sadly never encountered at all as an enemy in Half-Life 2 or Episodes 1 and 2. However, many players have seen its actions and animations demonstrated in Gmod, and its first appearance looks just as menacing as it's ever been, possibly suggesting that developers planned on Gordon Freeman encountering them later in the game, but scrapped the idea entirely for some unknown and unfortunate reason.
Number 26. Abominations. Fear 2.
Abominations are savage, humanoid cannibals appearing in Fear 2 Project Origin. They often wear hospital pants but are sometimes seen naked. They are extremely quick and have the ability to run on walls. Abominations prove to be dangerous to themselves as well, as they are sometimes seen with bandages wrapped around their heads and they always have severe wounds and rashes. At several points in the game they can be seen attacking enemies and brutally slaughtering them. They attack anything in sight and have absolutely no allies.
Number 25. Pursuit Cops. Mirror's Edge.
Pursuit Cops are located much later into the game, at Paradelic Kruger. They're elite blues, who have received runner training to be able to chase after runners. They're extremely agile and experts of hand-to-hand combat, attacking the player with flying kicks and dodging other attacks. They also appear to be more nimble than other runners, as in segments where the player must wall run to reach a certain area, the Pursuit Cop can simply jump up there. While the player is usually told to run away from them, they can be taken down, but since there can be usually three or more Pursuit Cops chasing after the player, it's rather risky. Pursuit Cops can also fire stun tasers at the player, halting their speed and mobility. Hearing the distinct running noise from the Pursuit Cops is unnerving to many players.
Number 24. Dr. Salvador and Chainsaw Maggiani. Resident Evil 4 and 5.
Both these enemies will strike fear into many Resident Evil gamers. Dr. Salvador in Resident Evil 4 will approach the player much faster than most Ganados. If he gets close enough, he will swing his chainsaw for an instant kill. The Chainsaw Mangini in Resident Evil 5 is very much the same, except he takes a little longer to actually perform his chainsaw attack, but nevertheless is still a huge risk at close range, and with lesser known enemies who are prone to setting up the attack from these chainsaw enemies, makes them a fear beyond belief. Still running away from them and hearing their demonic voice and revving of the chainsaw really unnerves the player.
Number 23. Shibito. Forbidden Siren series.
The Shibito are the main enemies of Forbidden Siren, Forbidden Siren 2, and Siren Blood Curse. In basic terms, the Shibito are corpses reanimated by supernatural forces, but unlike zombies, they retain a sense of intelligence and even a personality. In Forbidden Siren and Siren Blood Curse, the Shibito evolve into less human forms which appear more insect-like. Such forms include the Spider Shibito.
Number 22. Hammerhaunts. Thief.
Hammerhaunts are dead Hammerites with skeletal bodies, carrying a sword or hammer in their hand. The general problem with the Haunts is their battle skills. They move stunningly fast and it is impossible to outrun them. The frightening sounds they make, often disturbing or echoing laughter, whispering, and callings to Garrett to join them are particularly unnerving. Once they reach their target, they begin mercilessly attacking them with their weapons.
Number 21. Divider. Dead Space.
The loud, chilling groan of a Divider worked well to warn many gamers in advance of what a Divider actually was. Basically, they're extremely tall, thin necromorphs that are strong and tough. Once slain, the head, arms, and legs separate and become independent creatures. The Divider's subsections are very fast and will damage in an attempt to strangle players. Its tentacle lash attack would kill the player in one hit, if they refuse to put up a fight.
Number 20. Cyborg Midwives. System Shock 2.
Part woman and part cyborg, this horrifying creature moves robotically through the halls of the spaceship Von Braun and will whisper very strange things. Upon seeing the player, they let out a terrifying shriek and fire lasers at their direction. Their faces aren't good to look at either. They look like someone put a human body in a blender with computer parts. Spine-tingling horror, and way scarier than anything we've seen in Rapture.
Little ones need lots of meat to grow big and strong. I'll cut you in half, get away from the children.
Number 19. Replica Assassins. Fear.
Replica Assassins possess amazing speed and agility. They're also equipped with a cloaking device that allows them to become nearly invisible, resulting in a visual effect that resembles a distortion of air that fills their shape. Assassins can attach themselves to walls and give away their presence by a sound similar to that of rubber stretching. While they're extremely fast, they rely on physical melee attacks rather than weapons to attack. They fight with the hit-and-run tactics, striking first and then retreating into other rooms, onto walls or ceilings, or to higher ground. They do not speak, but produce a faint, high-pitched electrical sound when killed, along with harmless bursts of electricity.
Number 18. Deathclaw. Fallout 3.
Deathclaws are fast, huge, extremely dangerous hunters that burst forth from piles of rubble and deserted buildings. Their skin is nearly bulletproof, and they are constantly angered. They are led by the Deathclaw Matriarch, a territorial and powerful alpha female. But regardless of gender, size, or disposition, Deathclaws exist to kill, and they've perfected the art.
Number 17. Aliens and Facehuggers. Aliens vs. Predator series.
Aliens are fast and unpredictable enemies that have been long considered some of the most scariest enemies out there. They like to stalk the player in the dark and come forth and attack when they least expect it. Aliens are also the fastest type of enemy in the game and able to spit acid long distances. Players must be cautious not to step in the acid once an alien is killed. Facehuggers are small parasitoid creatures that attack the player from the floor and jump up onto the screen. They're the smallest enemy encountered in the game, and are seen hatching from eggs. The Facehugger's attack pattern bears similar styles to the Protozoid
Steen. Adult V-Rex. King Kong.
Adult V-Rex are the descendants of the Tyrannosaurus Rex and are the largest terrestrial predator on Skull Island. These enemies are huge and cannot be killed. They're an instant kill if the V-Rex manages to get close enough. The sheer size, realistic sound effects, and heavy stomps coupled with Jack's desperate breathing create a very scary, sinister, and formidable enemy.
Number 15. Chainsaw Zombie. Doom 3.
Once part of the maintenance staff at the UAC facility, instead of fixing the little problems around the base, these guys are now helping to create them. Seem to be armed with a chainsaw. They're faster than regular zombies, and laugh maddeningly upon sighting the player. The constant revving of the chainsaw, hurried breaths, and quick footsteps will fear the player to no end. Chainsaw zombies are usually found in industrialized areas behind dark corners.
Number 14. Ghosts. Silent Hill 4, The Room.
Ghosts are the tormented souls of Walter Sullivan's numerous victims which roam his world. They appear at walls and float around after the player. Even being near them is harmful, as players suffer from intense headaches and even take damage over time. Ghosts make zombie-like groaning noises and appear as rotten undead reflections of their former selves. Ghosts will endlessly stalk a player in the vicinity until they leave that room.
Number 13. Poison Zombie. Half-Life 2.
Poison zombies are bloated, reddish-purple, slow-moving menaces. They are almost always seen carrying an additional 2 or 3 poison head crabs on their back. Poison zombies themselves are not poisonous, and rely on the hitchhiking poison head crabs to attack first. The poison zombie appears to be several times stronger than its brethren. On multiple occasions, poison zombies can destroy entire doors and other objects in one swipe. What's scary about poison zombies are the poison head crabs themselves. Being hit by one of these will reduce the player to 1% health. While the health recharges back up again, the player can be instantly killed by weaker foes.
Number 12. Plaster Splicer. Bioshock.
Now, the idea may have been borrowed before in countless games, but it was no less startling. Case in point, areas you walk down are empty. Turn around and these white statues will appear behind you. Some are actual statues, but some are real and will attack. These splicers can be creepy as they attack in silence, unlike other splicers which scream and talk to themselves constantly. They prefer to come out of the shadows, and will often appear almost out of nowhere, making them very frightening at times. Some statue splicers will spawn right where the player is not looking, and remain posed until the player gets close before leaping into action. Some statue splicers will occasionally knock over mannequins or other monuments and stand in their place.
Number 11. Excreature. Return to Castle Wolfenstein.
They are the first results of Übersoldaten Project, and considered failures due to their unstable and feral nature. Excreatures are cyborgs who have their lowered body parts amputated and replaced with Tesla generators. The creatures are reinforced with drugs, making them very agile and fast. They have an ability to jump great distances and electrocute their enemies. They attack by jumping in the air and electrocuting their targets. It's a good tactic to attack the lopers from distance because their attacks can drain the player's health really fast and are difficult to hit.
Number 10. Creeper. Minecraft.
Since Minecraft seems to be of a community favorite, we really don't need to go that far with the creeper. Basically, it's night, you're mining when you fall down a cavern, pull out the torch, turn around, and there it is. Creepers generate a hissing sound and will enter players' homes and explode unexpectedly, leaving large craters in the ground, thus making players to start rebuilding their home all over again.
Number 9. Redeads. Zelda Ocarina of Time 64.
Redeads have long been regarded as some of the most horrible creatures in video game history. They huddle over, bidding their time as Link steps quietly past them. If they are disturbed, they freeze time around them and stalk Link with their hulking, tall figures shrieking through motionless mouths. If Link is unfortunate or careless enough to walk within their arm's length, the Redead will wrap around him and bite his neck and head.
Number 8. Crimson Head. Resident Evil Remake.
Essentially, they are zombies of zombies. If you forgot to set a zombie on fire after lighting it up, it will stand up red with anger and run even faster than it used to, and they take much more ammo to kill too. But most of all is their ability to break through closed doors, making them even more terrifying. In so many horror games, particularly Resident Evil games, a closed door allowed for a few calming breaths and a sign of relief. But that's not the case. Crimson Heads are enough to evoke nightmares. In addition to them being lightning fast, they're also unpredictable. To sum it up, Crimson Heads are more fearsome than hunters.
Number 7. Bloodsuckers. Stalker.
Bloodsuckers are a type of rare mutant usually found in the deeper areas of the zone. Perhaps the most peculiar thing about the Bloodsuckers is their optic camouflage, which allows them to temporarily become almost invisible to the naked eye. They'll often engage their camouflage upon discovering prey, and become visible again when they're close enough to attack. Bloodsuckers have thick skin and are very durable, being able to sustain large amounts of damage before dying.
Number 6. Witch. Left 4 Dead series.
As far as the infected go, no other creature is as lethal or as terrifying as a startled witch. She is found crouching in corners, or stumbling along, shielding her face and her scalpel's sharp claws. One false move, that's all it takes to turn the witch from a quiet, tearful mourner to a vicious and aggressive monster. And with her long, spiked fingers, it takes only a swipe or two to kill you. No sound, that is, except for the glass-cracking screech she lets out as she goes berserk, tearing at everything as she moves.
Number 5. Scarecrow. Fear, Perseus Mandate.
The Scarecrow is an apparition created by Alma, only seen in rare encounters of Fear, Perseus Mandate. A hideous and ghoulish creature, the Scarecrow appears as an upper torso with thin arms and large claws. The monster acts more like a trap, hiding inside large black cloaks that appear on the floor. Stepping into said cloak brings the Scarecrow to attack by holding the player still and viciously flailing its claws at him, a move that can disorient and frighten the player.
Number 4. Mannequins. Condemned criminal origins.
It's one of those moments in the game. You walk through a pitch-black room with your flashlight, passing by a couple of mannequins. Of course, when you turn around, you realize that they've moved. Then you hear a noise and realize they're marching towards you, jerkily. Mannequins are quite literally the most scariest enemies players will fight in Condemned Criminal Origins. While they're slower than a normal addict, they are slightly stronger and have a demonic glare, and bits of wax actually fall off them when they're attacked. Only seen in Bart's department store, mannequins are hoped to return in future sequels.
Number 3. Regenerators and Iron Maidens. Resident Evil 4.
Regenerators are a monster created by the Inhumane Experiments. Regenerators injured, small tentacles sprout from the wound and appear to knit new flesh, recreating entire limbs within seconds. Although they're usually slow, regenerators are capable of frightening bursts of speed when attacking. A regenerator may randomly run at the player and knock Leon down with its powerful arms, which is incredibly frightening to the player, as will happen randomly and quickly. Iron Maidens lack visible eyes and have a slower walking speed than regenerators, but can crawl much faster. Iron Maidens tend to use their spikes as weapons, having a special attack where they grab the player and pull them towards himself.
Number 2. Crawling Woman. Fatal Frame 3, The Tormented.
Player encounters this ghost, crawling under the floor of the Manor of Sleep, and later encounters her again in the attic above Yu's room and the Futon room. Crawling Woman is an extremely fast and unpredictable enemy that attacks the player from the shadows or from behind. There is usually a very eerie music played in this area, which makes the encounter all the more scary. Kiriko's character appears to have been inspired by a similar character from the J-horror film Ju-on: The Grudge.
Number 1. The Gatherers and the Infected. Amnesia, Dark Descent, and Penumbra, Black Plague.
A terrible group of monsters named Gatherers and Amnesia and Infected in Penumbra, Black Plague are one of the main enemies and by far the scariest, and there's no way to defend yourself against them. At first you only get glances of them walking around corners and then disappearing. Later, however, you are forced to run and hide as these monsters begin to appear abruptly, and more often than not, smashing through doors at some points. Frantic music chase, fast speed, as well as the horrible designs of the monsters themselves, will strike fear and panic into the hearts of gamers everywhere.